That event signaled what has become a confusion on the streets of Abia State. With Justice Okunabang's judgment and a certificate of return in Mr. Ogier's hands, the political atmosphere in the southeastern state has become heated. The governor has been explaining issues surrounding the controversial tax issue, while Mr. Ogier has been waiting in the wings to benefit from the judgment. In Lagos, the different sides of the divide have been speaking on what they feel is the right way to go. Here, INEC gets the bashing, and it's their view that external forces are responsible for the tension in the PDP in Abia State.
The Electoral Act provides that a person whose election gets nullified has 21 days, that is 504 hours, to file an appeal, and he will stay in office for as long as it takes to determine his appeal. So why has there been such an inordinate rush to do so within 24 hours, especially when Governor Ekpeazu had already filed an appeal as well as a motion for stay of execution, and INEC was duly served?
I think that the issue is that a fifth columnist entered the PDP in Abia State. And the fifth columnist has entered into an agreement by the opposition in the state to go through the back door, to take away what belongs to PDP, and to bring it and come and celebrate with the opposition. I think that that is the problem. There is no problem in PDP, and we know that backdoor arrangement will not stand.
Mr. Augustine is not keeping mute on the development. They stand on the premise of the court judgment and are earnestly seeking quick action.
People are mixing it up with Section 143, that deals with election tribunal matter. When a court, a tribunal has invalidated election of either a governor or a member of the legislative assembly, what happens is that you have 21 days within which to appeal. Now, if you appeal within 21 days, that appeal operates as a stay. It does not apply to pre-election matter. Tribunal decisions are different, and people are mistaken, oh, they should have waited for 21 days and other. It's only for tribunal decisions, not on pre-election matter, in which somebody that's supposed to have been the right candidate has been denied the opportunity of being there, of even sitting there as a governor, and somebody that's supposed not to be there is occupying that position, and he asks the man to wait. The principle behind obedience to court order, obedience to judgment, is that a successful litigant must enjoy the fruit of his success.
This issue will no doubt be a major legal and political development, not only for Abia State, but for the nation at large. Events of the coming days will be key in the eventual outcome of the impasse. Shewa Kimalue, Channels Television News.